Hello students, today we are going to discuss another type of connective tissue, and that is skeletal connective tissue, which includes bone and cartilage. So as we have earlier studied that the connective tissues are the tissues which help to connect the other kind of tissues together, and they are the supportive tissue. So we in the first video we had discussed about the fluid connective tissue, and in which we had studied about the blood and lymph. Here in this video we are going to discuss about the another kind of connective tissue, which is skeletal connective tissue, in which two types of tissues are there. One is bone and another is cartilage. So skeletal connective tissue is a type of connective tissue which is composed of solid matrix and cells. As we know, the connective tissues are composed of two main components. First one is matrix and another one is cells. So here in this case of skeletal connective tissue, the matrix is solid, in the form of solid, and in that solid matrix the cells are embedded. The main function of skeletal connective tissue is to provide support and protect the soft part of the body. Because it is solid, and that's why the tissues of skeletal connective tissues are supportive in nature. They provide support and protect the soft organs of the body, and it also gives shape and form to the body, because these bone and cartilage make the framework of the animal's body. Hence you can say that it also gives shape and form to the body. And it occurs in two forms, bone and cartilage. Skeletal connective tissue is of two types. One is bone and another is cartilage. So one by one we will discuss about the bone and cartilage. So let's talk about the bone. Firstly, the bone is a rigid, non-flexible and hard skeletal connective tissue, and consisting of cells embedded in an abundant hard intercellular matrix. Because bone is the hard tissue, so the matrix which is present in the bone, it is very hard and rigid, means it is not flexible. So bone is a very hard skeletal connective tissue, and the cells which are found in the bone, they are embedded into the rigid matrix of the bone. Now two principal components of matrix is collagen and calcium phosphate. The matrix of the bone is hard due to the presence of calcium phosphate, and one kind of fiber is found there, which is collagen. The cells which are found in the bone, they are called osteocytes. The bone cells are called osteocytes, and each bone cell is enclosed in a small fluid filled ring shaped cavity called lacuna. The arrangement of the cells, the arrangement of the osteocyte in the bone, is like they are found in the ring shaped cavity. Okay, and that ring shaped cavity is called lacuna, and these lacunae are connected together by several fine and branched canaliculi. The cavity in which the osteocyte is found, these cavities are interconnected with the branches named as canaliculi. And fine processes of osteocytes extend through these canaliculi and are connected with the processes of other osteocytes. The osteocytes are branched. The structure of osteocytes are branched. So the branches of the osteocytes run through the canaliculi and they are interconnected. So you can write the processes of osteocytes are interconnected and they run through the canaliculi. So osteocytes are present in the concentric ring around the central canal, and the central canal is called a Havertzian canal. Like you can see here in this diagram, here the central canal, the central aperture, or you can say the canal in which the blood vessels and nerves run, that canal is called Havertzian canal. And around the Havertzian canal there is a ring like structure, and that ring like structure are called as lamellae. In each lamellae you can see there is lacuna, there is a cavity. In that cavity the osteocyte is found, and you can see that there is a fine branching arised from the lacuna, and that branches are called canaliculi. And with the help of these branches the osteocytes are interconnected. So this is the this arrangement make a system in the bone, and that system is known as Havertzian system or osteon. It is called osteon or Havertzian system. Havertz's system having a canal in the central position, and in that canal the nerves and blood vessels run. Around that canal there are concentric rings, and that rings are called as lamellae. In the rings there are cavities. In that cavities the osteocytes are found, and the cavity named as lacuna. And more than one lacuna are interconnected with the branches, and that branches are known as canaliculi. And with the help of these canaliculi the one and more osteocytes are interconnected with each other. So this is the arrangement of the cells in the bone. Okay, and this lamellae, this concentric ring are made up of the hard matrix in the bone. Now the bone is made up of with this kind of Havertzian system, and lots of Havertzian system unite together, arrange together to make a complete structure of the bone. Like you can see in this diagram, there is a lacuna. Okay, this is the hard matrix in which the cavity is found, and that cavity is called as lacuna. In this cavity the bone cell is arranged, that is osteocyte. Okay, and that cavity, this lacuna which is the cavity, it is having branches. Okay, these is having canal like structure, and that canal like structures are called canaliculus. Okay, single canaliculus and plural is canaliculi. Now this is the one osteocyte arranged in the matrix. Here you can see the complete Havertzian system magnified. Here there you can see there are concentric rings, okay, one after the another, which is made up of hard matrix. And these in between these rings there are the so many lacuna, and in that lacuna, in each lacuna one osteocyte is found. Okay, and these osteocytes are communicated, connected together with the canaliculi. And in the center of these concentric ring you can find there is a canal, there is a tube like structure, there is a canal which is known as Havertzian canal, and in which the arteriole, venule and nerves run. Now this is the one osteon or Havertzian system. By uniting more than one Havertzian system, the complete bone structure is formed. Like you can say there are so many Havertzian system. This is the first one, second, third, fourth, and likewise the complete long bone will be formed. So this is the structure of the bone. In the hard matrix the osteocytes are arranged in a specific manner. Now we will talk about the functions of the bone. So बिकॉज बोन इज द हार्ड स्केलेटल कनेक्टिव टिश्यू सो इट फॉर्म्स द फ्रेमवर्क दैट सपोर्ट्स द बॉडी एज यू कैन टेक योर ओन एग्जाम्पल योर बॉडी हैज अ स्केलेटल फ्रेमवर्क विच इज मेड अप ऑफ बोन दैट सपोर्ट्स योर कंप्लीट बॉडी इट प्रोटेक्ट्स द वाइटल बॉडी ऑर्गन्स लाइक ब्रेन एंड लंग्स एट्सेट्रा यू नो दैट योर ब्रेन इज फाउंड इन अ ब्रेन बॉक्स विच इज नोन एज अ स्कल एंड दैट स्कल इज मेड अप ऑफ बोन ओके एंड इट दैट स्कल विच इज मेड अप ऑफ बोन इट protects the brain okay like you know that your lungs are protected by the ribs what are ribs ribs are the bones okay so ribs protect your lungs and heart in the thoracic chest region now it anchors the muscles bones provide the surface for the attachment of muscles so this is another work of bone and it provides shape to the body like animals get the shape of their body because of the framework of the bones so these are the main function of the bone it gives support to the body it protects the soft organs of the body it provides surface for the muscle attachment it provides shape to the animal's body So this is all about the bone. Now we will talk about the another skeletal connective tissue, which is cartilage. Cartilage is also a skeletal connective tissue, but in comparison to the bone, it is relatively soft and elastic. Okay, if you will compare the bone with the cartilage, then you'll find bone is very very rigid and hard, but cartilage is little bit softer and elastic than the bone and it consists of elastic matrix there in case of bone you have seen that the matrix of bone was very very hard due to the presence of calcium phosphate but here in this case of cartilage the matrix is elastic and composed of the protein known as chondrin and they have the collagen fibers and slightly the presence of calcium is there okay and that because of the presence of calcium it is slightly hardened but not as the bone okay now the cartilage cells the cells which are found in the cartilage are called chondrocytes the cells which are found in the cartilage are called chondrocytes the cells which were found in the bone that are called osteocytes and the cells which are found in the cartilage they are called chondrocytes and they are also found in the fluid filled spaces called lacunae here in this diagram you can see there's the matrix soft elastic matrix and in that matrix random lacuna are found random lacuna cavities are found that are called lacuna and in that cavity the chondrocytes are arranged in this diagram you can see the presence of cartilage so this is the diagram of knee okay where the two bones are meeting together this is the joint and here at the end of the bone you can see the covering of cartilage and this the covering of cartilage over the bone will protect both these bone from the wear and tear okay and that's how the cartilage provide the protection to the long bones at the place of joints so we have talked about the skeletal connective tissue which includes two type of tissues bone and cartilage both are the hard tissues which support the and provide framework to the animal's body so this is all about this video thank you